Hello world, welcome back to a new episode of Wandering Back to Europe. It's my second episode in a week, which is nice. I would just like to say before I start this episode, thanks for all the support, for all the welcome backs I got. It means a lot. You know, I haven't done anything football manager related for over a month, and yet I'm just grateful. Yeah, I'm so grateful. Thank you very much. So today, we start off slightly differently. We start off in a Leeds game because we're in the quarterfinals of the FA Cup. And also, it was a good, you know, opportunity for us to introduce you some youth players. Because, you know, you're not going to see them ever again, apart from maybe Joe Settle. This guy looks like a very good winger who has good, you know, technicals, pretty good physicals, apart from the strength. He just needs to hit the gym. But apart from that, he looks like a handy little winger and potentially quite similar to Spillane. However, fickle personality, which meant I had to create my own mentoring group. And yeah, so that's going to need to, he's going to need some work done, but hopefully he'll be fine. Look at that good potential. Apart from that, nothing much really. As you can see, only two people weren't signed. And yeah, I guess the next best one would be Walker. But again, just because of the determination and work rate, apart from that, just nothing whatsoever. So what has happened since the last game? Well, we played a few games. So the first game back was Coventry. We won 2-1. Comfortable game. Don't be fooled by the score because, you know, we were playing well. We kind of, once again, rotated because Coventry are, I haven't checked actually during the game, they're a bottom championship team. And, you know, there's nothing to take seriously. Harker played, you know, Nunes played, Ibrahim is getting more chances. You know, it's very important to actually rotate my squad a little bit. And here, we moved on to Everton, where Jordan Ross and Spillane ran riot against Everton. Everton could do nothing. 3-0 in the first half. And then we just subbed off a bunch of Bruno Araujo, got some games. Actually, Mendoza started. Mendoza, I really like him. He looks like he could be a pretty decent halfback. That's also quick, you know, I like that. Maybe I could improve his passing. So I think I'm actually training him to do it. I don't know. A lot of the times I am training them to play in positions that they may not be the best suited for, but because that's what I think the tactic needs. Maybe one day I'll sign a better player. But so far I have Fernandes and I have Mendes there as well. Here, Butland's continuing his scoring form. He scored another goal in his own net. And to be fair enough, you know, this was a weird one. This, you know, it's one of those when it hits the post and hits the back of the keeper. And it's like, well, you can't really do anything about that, can you? But both our strikers getting off, you know, and scoring two goals. It's very nice. And yeah, Petagna scored as well. And it's 2-2. Unfair. Really unfair. But hey. So we said we'd be back for the Tottenham game, but we're back for the Leeds game. And hopefully, it'll be a fun game. I'll show you when I have my team set up. And so here we are. So due to the fact that our next game is actually in a few days away, see, because we are on an international break, I have the opportunity to play a full squad, and a full squad I'm playing. So Butland in goal, I'm giving Timon a chance because he hasn't been playing as much. I know Zagre is in a better form, but, you know, Timon needs to play as well. Braithwaite and Tuanezbe continue their partnership. It's quite a nice partnership. Tuanezbe kind of grew out of his kind of crappy form at the start, so that's nice. Raskazov is on as well, as always. Who else? We have no other, I guess, good right back. So our other right back is Araujo. And to be fair, hopefully he will get a bit more game time. And talking about that, I will bring him on instead of Zagre, because he can play both left and right. So more game time for him. Mateus Fernandes play with Gujman. Gujman continue his very hot form. Spillane on the left. Vera in the middle, who's apparently not playing so well with Ross. And then right, we're going with Ibrahim. Again, some chances. I know I said I don't want to rotate, but I still don't want to make some. I want to give people chances to play, you know. But yeah. So if you're watching this, as always, you know, leave a like, subscribe, and yeah, show it to your friends, your family, and, you know, whoever has a technical device of any sort. You can watch it from a microwave. I don't know. But yeah, I'm really, like I said, I'm really grateful for all the support I got. And nice welcome back. So that's really, I'm really grateful, especially for the fact that the last video, I mean, apart from the video I released on Monday, the last video was in the 1st of August. So yeah. And as I'm talking, the game takes a long time to warm up, so I will see you when it loads up. So, we're back, the game loaded, and we're ready to go. And I just realized the reason why I really like playing on first of all, key highlights, but also showing the whole game, is that I get to talk, and it's nice, hopefully. You know, it's like a small version of streaming, because streaming takes way too long, but at least in this way, we can have some sorts of conversations and play at the same time. So, I guess, you know, if you're watching this, what have you been up to? Have you done anything cool? Like, since, obviously, we're a bit more freer to do stuff, have you done anything interesting? Like, taking a trip somewhere? I don't know, tell me, write in the comments. I've been kind of sitting here doing some freelance sometimes. Just, you know, taking care of the house. My girlfriend's working still. I still have no job, technically, but I'm doing some freelance. And apart from that, you know, just playing video games. I've actually finished the expansion for Witcher. I know it's quite a long time. Witcher 3. I've done, what's it called? Hearts of Stone? Yeah, Hearts of Stone. Great one. And I'm playing Blood and Wine, not Wine and Blood. So, yeah. That's what I've been up to, pretty much. Just reading, trying to, since we're moving, I said we're moving, I'm trying to read as many books as I can so I can deliver and give them off, give them away, so I don't have to bring them to a next house. And yeah. So, ooh, Deschamp. Is that the same Deschamp? It's not the same Deschamp. I know it isn't. But yeah. So, my rambling is done. And yeah, nothing happened here. Apart from that one kind of good... Is that... Oh yeah, this is the team. I forgot. Leeds had Keane Bryan, so... And Mr. Darcy, they both transferred here quite recently for 15 million each. So hopefully they won't have a good time, and they don't have a good time because Nikolai Raskazov scores is, well, with a great first time finish. Was it a first time finish? My brain doesn't process things quick enough. You know, I'm not used to talking and, you know, actually thinking at the same time. Normally you just kind of watch it and you go, nice. But no. Okay, so Ibrahim kind of takes everyone away, and then Raskazov. First time touch, all the way to the left. Let's go. Let us go. Good stuff. Good start. We're playing well. But, you know, a lot of this, you know, the problem with playing smaller teams is that they can punish you. And Mateus Fernandez clears. Is Ross going to cling to it? Nope. Deschamp passes all the way to the back to, ooh, a Korean goalkeeper. Nice. Gabriel. Along to the left. Will Raskazov stop Jensen? No, he will not. Gabriel again hoofs it to the left side because he realizes no one's going to get past Raskazov. Vera intercepts our attacking midfielder playing defender as well. Spillane blows past Deschamps. Is he going to finish? Does he have the finishing? And did Ibrahim just try to score that goal? But it didn't count. Spillane scored. Ooh, cheeky, cheeky. I like that. It was a bit of a, you know, Ronaldo nanny sort of situation. Except the ball actually went in and Ibrahim was not offside, so that's nice. Let's take a look again. Good finish. And Ibrahim... No, to be fair, it looked like he bodied off Bryan. Or maybe Bryan just wanted the goal to go in, you know. It was 15 million plus a goal from Bryan. That's the exact transfer value. And we're winning 2-0. That's very good. So, that's a very good performance for us. Potentially, we need to score one more. And then I can get Zalewski and Arujo to join. To play a little bit. They need experience. And Vera steps up. And the second, third goal goes in. We make a sub. And that's not the case so far. Good interplay. I'm really liking this formation. I like the fact that, you know, Fernandes kind of drops a bit lower. And, you know, we're a bit more solid at the back for Spillane. To absolutely no one. El Ghazi clears it. Braithwaite. I like that he's fitting in here. It's very nice. Very nice, Braithwaite. Good interplay as always. Darcy knows that we like to dilly-dally on the ball. Is he going to do something cool? He takes a shot and Butlin sees it. What? Okay. Who's Sombyonkun? Oh, not bad. We have a Korean goalkeeper playing the championship. That's quite a nice. So we're going to take off our captain. We're going to take off Braithwaite for that little bit of a mistake. You know, keep him on his toes a little bit. Let's tell him to get creative. I want more goals. I want to go for blood. I want to, you know, relax and chill. As opposed to not relax and not chill. But maybe bringing on two youngsters is not a good idea against Leeds. Never discount Leeds. That's what we learned from the Leeds documentary. And the fact that they got promoted this year. So that's cool. I missed a lot, didn't I? McBurney? Lefay? Is he going to cross it? Yes, he is. Arujo cannot cover, but Fernandez should. Bryan crosses it in to Darcy. Darcy had his chance. Oh, that won't be nice if Darcy scores against me. I will kind of cry. I mean, we left on good terms, so no hard feelings there. Maybe I will be a proud little, proud parent. You know, hopefully he can come back to the Premier League and fulfill his potential. I think he had good potential, but he did stagnate. And that's mostly because of the fact that we were jumping up and I needed some players. And yeah, he could have stayed, but 15 million was way too good. I need the money. Livermento, somebody stop him. Timon misses the ball. El Ghazi, and there we go. That's what happens when you have a unexperienced right back. El Ghazi scores from a corner. Eh, 2-1. Not too bad. Not too bad. Let's tell him to get creative again because we're not actually making any chances. Gujman, Spillane. Timon, come on, buddy. Clear forward. No. Oh, this is not good. I think we need to drop back, actually. Oh, I think it was a mistake bringing on two youngsters. Spillane. Okay, good. Counter. We need to counter. They should be the one countering, but we're countering. Ross, not as clinical. Not as clinical. Oh, what a shame. What a shame. Oh, we have one more sub. I completely forgot that. Yeah, Ross is playing crap. I'm thinking, actually. Should I get Hansen a run out or should I get Fernandez a run out? Let's do something like this. Ibrahim. Wait, what am I doing? No, wait. Ibrahim's going to come in here. Oh, yeah, perfect. It's all perfect. Part of the plan. Vera will go stay in his position. And actually, Hansen's going to play on the right instead of Ibrahim. So it's nice. Maybe the guy can actually play up front like he normally does. Or he should. Gooden to play in the middle as always. That's part of our Bolton style that we're doing. Sam is not going to be happy. And Spillane finishes, but he's offside. He is offside. Unfortunate. Quite unfortunate. Oh, man. At this moment, you hate VAR. But at the same time, if you're Leeds, you're happy. Because now you have the chance. And here you go. We look at Timon. Mistakes. Do you reckon Hansen's got, you know, 7 to 10 minutes to impress? Well, 10 minutes, actually. And again, 2-1 against a weaker side. I'll take it. You know, we were comfortable. We were never troubled. Should we do this? Yeah, let's go. Why not? You know, keep them on the toes. I think it's very important. Man of the match goes to Mateus Fernandez, which is really good because he does exactly what I need. He's a bit of a mobile player, slotting in a halfback, you know, comfortable on the ball, comfortable defending, you know, all perfect rounder. If Mendoza can improve some aspects of his play, he can start, you know, worrying about it. But Mateus Fernandez is doing really well. I remember a few years back, I used to play him as a volante, Mateus Fernandez, I mean. And in previous football managers, he's really good. I mean, if you look at how good he is for his role, he is a box-to-box. But if you play him a halfback, it's not really anything that's, you know, bad for it. He is a perfect all-rounder player. And yeah, a perfect box-to-box. But we don't play with a box-to-box. And, you know, I like it. That's good. But yeah, you compare him to Mendoza, and Mateus Fernandez is much better. But he does have 5 years, I guess. He's senior of him. Played for Barcelona as well. He played for Barcelona. Wait, is he at Barcelona? Whoa. Nice, I didn't realize. Yeah, so he played no games for them. Played a bunch for Barcelona B, then played in Girona. And back to Internacional, and then with us. So that's nice, I guess. Yeah, very good player for 3 million. Incredible. It just shows how good I am at finding transfer targets. But yeah, so we won. I wonder who we're going to get drawn against. Can we find out? When are we going to find out? Let's take a quick look. Okay, let's not take a quick look. So there are us two have to play later today. We'll find out on the 25th. That's in 2 days. Should we bother simming? Yeah, let's bother. So the plan is, ideally, we'll see you for the Tottenham game. No, we won't. We'll see you for the unknown FA Cup semi-final game, because now it comes to the very interesting stuff. Ooh, I'm excited. Are you excited? Let's take a look. Who are we going to get? Okay, so after a quick simulation, fast forwarding, we're back. And we have a choice of Liverpool, Arsenal, Leicester, and, well, obviously us, but we can't draw us. So who would you want to pick? I definitely think Leicester. Ooh, we'll take a C. Well, versus Arsenal. And looks like we already know. So the first one, we're going to be playing Arsenal. Yikes. So we could have played Tottenham next, but no, we decided to play the other, London rivals. Arsenal. Ooh, they look like they're trying to fight for the title. So hopefully we can try and frustrate them, and maybe we can actually make sure that they don't win it. But yeah, the choice is between Liverpool and Arsenal, and it's an easy choice. Of course you want Liverpool to win. And hey, we're actually leading somewhere. We have Splaines for player of the match, which is nice. And we got Braithwaite for number of yellow cards. And he is, well, let's say he's the top. They're all on 10. I don't know if that's what I want. Taya Wonyi, no way. Taibo, he is a top scorer. What? The Liverpool man went on loans forever, finally being sold. And he's been scoring, you know, 14 goals kind of steadily now. You know, 12. Ooh. Steady. I mean, to be fair, his pace is incredible. Yeah, he's definitely a speed merchant. And this looks something I'd be interested in, but I don't like the wages. Anyways, thank you for watching. Today we played, good question, who we played? We played Leeds. And next episode, which will be hopefully next Monday, we will play, drumroll please, Arsenal. I don't know why I said drumroll please, but yeah. We'll see you on Saturday of the 20th of April, 2024. Hopefully, it won't actually take 4 years to release the video. All right, guys. See you in the next episode.